Galan is patient, showing him. He knows the power in the hands of Onglan Sam. Onglan's going to take his time. He'll try and look for a takedown. Try and put Galan on his back.
Deep this choke was. He immediately jumps guard. Ungulati knew that was it and was forced to tap his way out.
Aung Lan Sung, the most famous personality in Myanmar. An entire nation behind him.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Olivier Coast, put a stop to this contest after 4 minutes and 31 seconds in the first round for your winner by way of guillotine choke, Aung Lan Sung.
Aung Lan Sung, the Burmese python, wrapped the python around the neck of Gulani and tapped him out in stunning fashion.
Second round, two strong women with power. Spinning back kick from Jenny Huang, but...
I like how she set that up, Steve. Faked the roundhouse, came around with the left for a hook. It's like a spinning crescent kick. Well done.
I always think when you do that spinning back kick business, you do sometimes expose yourself a little bit, and she did take one or two blows as a result.
The creativity and the adjustments in the striking are there from Jenny Huang. She looks to be utilizing a lot more footwork, not standing stationary, consistently throwing out that jab, and just attacking from awkward angles. Big takedown, and Jenny Huang jumped guard there, possibly threatened a guillotine, but she looks like she's a bit high. Maybe Yamaguchi's easily able to throw that off.
That's the creativeness that we've come to expect from Jenny Huang. She doesn't always do the orthodox thing. She's very imaginative in her moves.
Overhand right there again from Mei Yamaguchi. That seems to be her bread and butter when it comes to the striking game.
Yeah, from this position, Mei will, if she can get in close, look to free her hands up, land those punches. The ground and pound is something she's enjoyed already in this contest, and she'll look to throw in those forearms and elbows as well.
You know, with our judging criteria, it's not necessarily the person on top that is winning the round. If you're on bottom and you're threatening submissions and also striking from the bottom, you can actually edge out a lot of the categories from the bottom.
The up kick there is a particularly dangerous move for the person standing up to receive. You should be wary of the go-go platter as well, Yamaguchi.
But I think the entire atomweight division is wary of the go-go plata. Lady Go-Go can throw it up so easily. Nice little half-guard adjustment to prevent Mei Yamaguchi from sliding fully past her guard there.
Right above us here at cage side, and three times now, Mei Yamaguchi has picked up Jenny Huang and thrashed her back towards the canvas, and the crowd making noise as she does it. She digs in with right hands as well. Gets her right hand around the throat of Jenny Huang, but doesn't look as if she can do too much damage from there, Mitch.
Really, she's in danger of getting past. Yup, Mei Yamaguchi was able to use those strikes to the body to pass the guard, but nice adjustment again from Jenny Huang to avoid the dangerous mount position and to stay in half guard.
Not a comfortable time for her, though, in terms of blows to the face. The knees come close once or twice, but it's the left and the right, and that was a superb left punch going downwards. She just thought about drawing back that knee again. May, she hasn't quite landed it yet, but it's in her mind, and that knee to the head of her grounded opponent is particularly dangerous.
A lot of sneaky strikes coming through from Mei Yamaguchi on top. You can see her not really going for a lot of big, powerful strikes, but a lot of short, crisp punches that are sliding right past the defense of Jenny Huang. Now she's in full mount position. This is a bad spot for Jenny to be, and she's got to create movement. She's got to move those hips just a little bit to get back into half guard.
Arms around the neck, Mitch, to pull her in, but both arms free, and Mei can pound with left and right here.
Yeah, but she's negating the ability for Mei Yamaguchi to posture up like she's doing right now and create that space to drop those punches.
Now Mei's got her back. Arms underneath the chin.
Watch out for the rear naked choke. She hasn't got the second arm on it, and Jenny did well, but the other arm goes round now. And this is very dangerous. It could come the tap. Has it? Yes, it is. Mei Yamaguchi has won this one in the second round with just over a minute left. Rear naked choke, and she's back, Mitch, on the title trail.
That's a huge win for Miss Yamaguchi to get a rear naked choke off the Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu specialist, Jenny Wong. Huge win here in Yangon. Rear naked choke, Mei Yamaguchi.
What an athlete this 34-year-old woman is. To be fair, she just had the edge in about every aspect of the fight up until this point. Took a right hand there.
Look at this. Here's where Jenny Huang attempted the jump guard into a guillotine, but once it got to the ground, Mei Yamaguchi was able to control the positions. And you can see Jenny Huang wasn't even able to fight the position. That's how deep this choke was. Once she came under the neck, right here, you can just see her lock it up and grab the bicep, and Jenny Huang is forced to tap. Brilliant exhibition.
Improves her record to 16-10-1 with the official decision. Anthony Suntai.
To present the medal for this fight, we have Mr. Aung Koko, Deputy Managing Director of First National Insurance. Ladies and gentlemen, referee Olivier Coste calls a hold to this battle at 4 minutes of round number two. For your winner, by submission, via rear naked choke, Mei Yamaguchi!
Two really capable women. It was a shame that only one of them would come away with a win tonight. It turns out that it was the Japanese woman, Mei Yamaguchi. She does it again, shows her power and also her ability to win by submission.
Second round of three. Now, once again, both men said it would not go past two rounds. This is the round that Sung Jun Lee said he would knock out Gary Tonin in.
Sung Jun Lee's got to put that jab out there. He's got to ask Gary Tonin's closing the distance. Sung Jun Lee's got to utilize the jab. Gary Tonin's utilized throwing way too many jabs.
Counter right hand there from Sung Jun Lee. The head movement again from Tonin. The boxing has improved out of sight, particularly the jab of Tonin. High up against the balls of his feet, working the kicking arsenal now. There's a front kick to the midsection from the American. Dances back to center cage. Outside leg kick, inside leg kick. A striking display here, 101 from Gary Tonin.
This is a very different striker from the second time that we saw him.
You know what, Mitch, we're seeing the kicks here from Tonin, but Sung Jun Lee began his martial arts career in the national Korean art of Taekwondo, an art renowned for its kicking arsenal.
And he hasn't thrown a kick yet.
Nope. 2016 Naganogi Grappling Championship at under 160 pounds. Sung Jun Lee, purple belt in BJJ, loves the heel hook. Imagine slapping a heel hook on Gary Tonin. Don't think it'll happen. Let's see if he can swing for a knockout here in the second round. Gary Tonin, look at the movements on Tonin. Circles off clockwise, now drifts to his right. Full of confidence oozing out of every pore here for Gary Tonin. The jab, and oh, look at the evasion of the takedown. That was sweet, that was sleek.
That was beautiful, slid out of the way. Oh, nice little butterfly sweep there, but he's giving up the game.
Oh, this is trouble!
You don't want to give your neck to Gary Tonin. He's going to keep adjusting until he finds it. But Sung Jun Lee did a good job there of swinging over into half guard. Got it in side control, but look at Gary Tonin. He adjusted it in. Oh, that's there.
Oh, hold on. Wait a minute. Let me put some Tonin in it. Gary Tonin does it again. He is 3-0, and he is looking simply superb.
Sung Jun Lee gave him too many opportunities with that choke. He got it once. Sung Jun Lee did a good job of moving around, trying to fight it off, but Gary Tonin got it twice, didn't quite have it. Third time, look at these adjustments. This is world-class grappling on display right here. He's like, nope, don't quite have it here. Let me make this minor adjustment. You come in over into me, I'm gonna let you come into me, and then I'm gonna take you on top, mount you, and then I'm gonna finish you.
If you go to ground with Gary Tonin, if you take a trip to Toninville, don't expect to leave. Sung Jong Lee found that out the hard way. And might I say, Gary Tonin prophetic. He said he'd finish Sung Jong Lee inside of two rounds. And he did just that. Gary Tonin suffers a little cut under the left eye. Great sportsmanship displayed by both these martial arts warriors. But it's Gary Tonin who in his MMA career now goes 3-0. Let's go to Dominic Lau.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Olivier Coste, has called a stop to this contest after 2 minutes and 4 seconds in the second round. For your winner, by way of guillotine, Gary Tonin!
3-0, a 100% finishing rate, competing at featherweight tonight, and he looked absolutely superb.
Go, and look at Bibiano immediately going after the single leg.
Oh, Bibiano Fernandez, house on fire in the opening second. This fight brought to you by Monster Energy.
This first grappling exchange is gonna tell us a lot. We know that Andrew Leone's strength is his grappling, but grappling is Bibiano's superpower.
At the height of his BJJ career, Bibiano is considered the best of his generation. Only lost 5 times in his entire BJJ career. That's incredible. Leone, collegiate wrestler from Missouri College.
Trying to get that single leg, trying to suck it in. Andrew's got that overhook on the left side of Bibiano. He's trying to pull him up so he can get away from the hips.
Little popping right hands there from Bibiano Fernandez. Overhook on the left arm from Leone.
Turn hard, pop the hit. Remember to breathe, Andrew. Watch his strikes off.
Plenty of instructions coming from the corner of Andrew Leone, the team from Bali MMA.
Watch those strikes and circle off the page.
I think Bibiano's trying to make a very clear statement that this
is his. Oh, the knee hurt him! The knee hurt Leone! Here comes the flash! Here comes Bibiano! The ground and pound! Now he takes the back! Leone in all sorts of bother here! Bibiano Fernandez, a house on fire, raining down the blows. He looks to Yuji Shimada. He wants Yuji to stop it, but it's not going to happen. Leone surviving, but for how long? Bibiano continues to unload. Leone's going to get out of here. Bibiano with a choke. Can he choke him? Can he finish him? That's good night, Irene. Bibiano Fernandez brings the house down. A first round finish. The most dominant fighter in one championship history does it again.
What a statement by the champion. Beautiful, you said it, Michael. The knee was what did the damage. Crumpled Leone to the ground, and Bibiano swarmed on Leone with a grounded pound. Looked at the referee, asked him to stop it. Yuji Shimada said no, so he goes to the choke.
That's why they call him the Flash, because he can finish you faster than a speeding ticket. Bibiano Fernandez swarming Andrew Leone. And my word, the domination of this man, Fernandez, is simply remarkable.
Look at this, the rear naked choke ends the show in Macau.
What a show indeed from Fernandez. Bibiano continues his dominance, truly unstoppable. His 8th win here at one championship, and maybe his most emphatic. Andrew Leone is absolutely gutted. Let's go to Dominic Lau to make it all official.
And to present the prize for this fight, we have Mr. Gary Choi, Southeast Asia Country Manager for Monster Energy. And now, your referee, Mr. Yuji Shimada, has put a stop to this fight after 1 minute and 47 seconds in the first round. For your winner, by way of rear naked choke, and still one championship, bantamweight world champion, Bibiano Fernandes.
What a moment for the martial arts world. What a moment for a sellout crowd in Macau. And wherever you're watching in 128 countries around the world, you are seeing a martial artist of the highest pedigree. You are seeing history in the making, because that man, Bibiano Fernandes, is still the most dominant fighter in ONE Championship history. He is still the greatest bantamweight fighter on the planet. He is still the hottest martial artist in the world.
And Cohen bounds out of his corner. He switched between southpaw and orthodox in the opening round. And he opens up a southpaw here in the second.
Shiba's got to be careful rushing in like that. That's what this fire's going to be, that takedown.
Lovely counter right hand there from Shiba.
Ate the body kick, but to counter with a right hand of his own.
Oh, beautiful, almost taekwondo. Jumping roundhouse kick there from Shiba. Both men do a little posturing, a little posing. The crowd enjoys it. Two highly skilled martial arts athletes at the peak of their powers, Mitch.
Just big whiff on that kick. Both of them calling their shots, pointing to the upper deck.
Jab from Shiba.
Now we're starting to see the swagger start to ooze out of McLaren. This is what we saw in the Bibiano fight. If he wasn't doing so much posturing, if he wasn't doing so much showboating, I think he could have caught, he might be holding the bantamweight belt right now. I don't want to see him get caught up too much in this and have too much fun in there. I want to see him start to put it on in Shiba, because Shiba ain't falling for it.
It's a little something called the Aussie larrikin nature. And it's coming out again here in Reese McLaren.
Larrikin?
Larrikin nature. A rascal, a larrikin, that's what Reese McLaren is. But it's also a way for McLaren to try and get inside of Shiba's head. Shiba comes forward with track line punches. Goes for the inside leg. McLaren hasn't switched to orthodox. He's maintained the southpaw stance. Tries for a takedown, uppercut, hook combination from McLaren. Nice hand, left hand, didn't turn the knuckles in.
Like I said, he's going after the lower leg. He's going after that calf and shin of McLaren, which is going to slow down that shot. I'd like to see him keep doing it. Throw those punches, throw that low kick.
Overhand right there from McLaren. Shiba jab, sprawls out nicely. Good takedown defense from the Malaysian. Eats a left hand to the jaw. Looks for the hamstring there. Does McLaren.
Goes for a knee tap there.
High knee! Misses. Trying for the meet and greet. The Muay Thai technique from Reese McLaren. Shiba locks him up. McLaren breaks out. Shiba comes forward. A little sloppy on execution of those two straight punches. Look at the feet here on both these men, the way they stand. You'll see McLaren's back foot is very, very solid out, much more so than Johnny Shiba's.
He's having a hard time moving back. He takes about two steps forward, and that's where Shiba's connecting him.
McLaren hoped for a takedown. Gets a takedown. Shiba on his back. McLaren's got him melted again.
Falls
now passes
mount
to side control. Here's the choke.
Arm triangle.
Here's
deep.
The choke.
Done, Michael. Dove into the double leg. Let's take a look at that one more time. That was so pretty. He dove into the double leg, slides over, gets the arm triangle, and just puts the squeeze on. There's the Lee family.
Angela Lee, Bruno Pucci, Christian Lee. Angela will be taking on Mei Yamaguchi in a rematch in May in Singapore. But here's what went down in this incredible finish.
Look at that double leg, got the knee tap, fell into the top position, got the mount right into the arm triangle, and that's how big, how strong of a squeeze that McLaren's got. Shiba, no place to go. Taps Reese McLaren into a world title shot.
The most dangerous creatures in the world are in Australia. And you just saw one of them named Reese McLaren. Let's go to Dominic Lau.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Olivier Coste, has put a stop to this contest after 3 minutes and 12 seconds in the second round for your winner by way of arm triangle, Reese McLaren!
A beautiful round of applause from this Malaysian crowd for Reese McLaren. They appreciate great martial arts here in Malaysia, and they appreciate a great martial artist like Lightning, Reese McLaren. The Aussie gets the title shot, and he did it in emphatic fashion. Shinya Aoki, former world champion, bounds out of his corner.
Shinya's looking to close the distance, slide under the punches, just like that.
Almost caught him coming in with that tagging right hand, puts Aoki against the cage. Peppering rights there from the Russian.
Good job for Yakiyaev to spin him around, has a deep underhook on the left side. But Shinya Aoki flies into an armbar into an alma plata.
Not where Yakiyaev wants to be. You don't want Aoki on top of you. Not this early anyway.
We were talking about the creativity, and that is a perfect example of it. Beautiful. He's known for his flying triangles. He's known for his flying arm bars. And that was a beautiful transition from an arm bar into an omoplata. Now Shinya's on top, creating a lot of heavy top pressure.
One of the finest BJJ exponents in the sport, Shinya Aoki, top position on Russell Yakiyaev. Where does Yakiyaev go from here, Dragon?
Well, first he's got to create a little bit of space, so he's got to try to get that left arm underneath Shinya Aoki's right arm to carry a bit of an underhook. He's trying to frame off the face to do that, to create a little bit of space so he can get that in there. Hard time, but a deep, look at that. Just look at the pressure. I know the squeeze. I have been on the bottom with Shinya Aoki. He is so strong. His hands look like a bunch of bananas. They're so big, and he's got so much top pressure.
Watch out your head.
Still top position here for Shinya Aoki. We are joined by world's heavyweight champion, The Truth, Brandon Vera. Brandon, great to be here. What a night in Singapore.
This is an amazing time. I've never been to the stadium here, indoor arena, and it's this crowd is live. The fights are amazing. God, thank you for having me.
It's great to have you here, champ. And we're seeing Shinya Aoki, Mitch, in control of Russell Yakiyaev.
Shinya seems very comfortable just to stay here in half guard. He's not trying to pass. You can see the sort of the position that Yakiyaev has, almost a lockdown position where the legs threaded under, but Shinya's trying. Now he's trying to pass. He's trying to slide the knee up, trying to get through. Yakiyaev made his debut in ONE Championship and looked real good against Shannon Weirichai, put on a very impressive game plan. So I hope that transitions here and he can figure out a way to get out of this heavy top pressure from Shinya Aoki.
Brandon, if you're in the corner of Yakiyaev, what are you telling the Russian to do here off his back?
He needs to get that pressure off of his chest, get his back up on the fence, wall walk, and get up so he's not underneath Shinya. This is the worst position for him to be in.
Aoki looking at take-home. No, is it an omoplata there, Mitch?
Beautiful transition into a triangle. Got the mount from the triangle position. Has it deep. Yakiyaev's trying to punch his way out of it. But as he's doing that, Shinya's adjusting. He's taking the punches to get that triangle even tighter.
I thought we may have seen a more passive Aoki tonight, but he has brought the grappling aggression early on here. Look at this triangle.
Oh,
Yakiyaev in all sorts of bother.
Armbar on the right side, Michael.
Oh,
double threat right there, had the triangle, got tighter and tighter as Yakiyaev was trying to punch his way out, but then caught him in a straight arm lock and got the arm bar finish. That is impressive. That is classic Aoki. Two submissions in one.
Brandon Vera, we've seen two guys back-to-back who want to crack at the lightweight championship again. Edward Flying and now Shinya Aoki. That was classic.
That would be a beautiful matchup. Classic striker versus the ground guy. This submission, like you said, the 2-for-1 package that he gave him, was perfect. You couldn't ask for anybody to be more calm, collected, and cool in there during the match.
What an aggressive opening round from Aoki, back and doing it big time.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Olivier Coste, has put a stop to this contest after 3 minutes and 15 seconds in the first round. For your winner, by way of triangle choke, Shinya Aoki!
Shinya Aoki brings the house down in Singapore. Another submission of the highest order from a man who can do them the very best, and he can do them all.
The bell in round number one. This world title fight is brought to you by Fun 88. Belling on in the red trunks, the champion Fernandez in the black trunks, and immediately to the ground on the outside trip.
Yeah, this is not where Kevin Bellegong wanted to be. You can see Bibiano just kind of sliding past into side control. I think a mount is just a momentary delay. You can see the pressure that Bibiano applies. When you're on the top and you're in an offensive position, you don't want to give your opponent space. If you're on the bottom, you want to create space and move away as far away from your opponent. And you can just see Bibiano smothering Kevin Bellegong in this particular position.
Fernandez told us, I want to implement my Muay Thai early. I know my Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu is always there. Change of strategy, perhaps on the fly. Fernandez saw the opening. He sees the opening. And Bellegong back to his feet, full credit. And taken right back down by Bibiano Fernandez. Fernandez just so sticky with his jiu-jitsu.
Yeah, once he gets a hold of you, it's real difficult to get him off. Bibiano is out there at AMC training with, you know, Demetrius Johnson every day, just high-level training partners. You know, and Kevin Bellegong has got great training partners out there too at Team Lakai. But it just, I don't think he's faced the type of grappler that Bibiano is.
It's difficult to find even high-level training partners who can emulate the jiu-jitsu of Bibiano Fernandez. You see the control. Look at the movements of the lower body and the upper body of Fernandez.
Yeah, I got to spend some time out there at AMC and spend, you know, and train with Bibiano. And it's just so demoralizing to get on the ground with this guy. He just covers you, and it really feels like you're wrestling with a shark inside the water. And you just have no idea what he's going to do, but you know the kill is coming.
Fernandez hooking the leg.
You can just see the pressure that he's applying to his left shoulder to keep Bellegong's head in that position.
Winning from Olivier Coste, Bellegong. Punch to the back of Bibiano Fernandez's head. Fernandez.
He's got the
tenaciously inside control.
He's got the hip trapped with his right arm. He's got the head trapped with his left arm. And it pretty much just sprawls Kevin and secures him into that position. And there's nowhere that he can go.
Bellegong trying to throw those up knees. He landed one a moment ago. But difficult to generate any force on those knees, even if they land flush.
Go, guys, work.
Call for action from Olivier Coste.
You can see Kevin, he's got the right idea. You see how he's keeping his right knee so close to the body of Bibiano. That prevents Bibiano from stepping over and getting a more dominant position, such as the mount. From this position, it's hard to say, you know, how much energy Kevin is exerting. But, you know, when you're trying to fight for position, you're like struggling for your life. It's so difficult down there. And there's got to be an element of fear, you know, in Kevin Bellegong. So that's going to tax him a little bit as well. But this position can be incredibly draining and also demoralizing as well. You can't get out of his position.
And Fernandez is not going to park inside control. He's continually hunting for submissions.
Grab the fence, give
in. Bellegong trapping the right arm of Fernandez. Full marks for that. Fernandez yanking his right arm free.
See, but with that trap, you know, by trapping his arm, he enabled Bibiano to slide that knee now across his belly, which gives him a better position. And now,
looking for the arm bar now is Fernandez.
That's a nasty Kimura he's giving.
Kimura, there's the tap. Went for the straight arm bar, transitions into the Kimura, and finishes. 11 straight wins, 4 successful title defenses. Bibiano Fernandes continues to reign supreme. Simply dominant for the champion, Bibiano Fernandes. Patience mixed with skill equals first round submission finish. Took the arm, straightened it, then switched to the Kimura for the tap. That was slick and that was world class. Now 19-3 in his pro MMA career is Bibiano Fernandes. He remains firmly on top of ONE Championship's bantamweight division. Trapping the body of Bellingon, nowhere for Kevin Bellingon to move, and that's a tap or snap situation on the deep Kimura.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Olivier Coste calls a halt to this battle at 4:04 of round number one. For your winner by submission, via Kimura, and still the ONE Bantamweight World Champion, Bibiano the Flash Fernandes!
Rich Bibiano Fernandes, the first fighter in the young history of ONE Championship to successfully defend the world title 4 times.
Ready? Fight!
This fight brought to you by LG Electronics Singapore. Right hand from Hill, straight off with a knee to the body. It's a busy start. Angela Lee wraps up her opponent and they exchange knees. Hill's hand in Lee's face and she's getting a bit of a shock here because that was a heavy right hand from Natalie Gonzalez-Hills.
Natalie's landing some nice shots inside the clinch, which is kind of surprising considering that this fight has not yet gone to the, you know, to the ground. I think Angela would immediately try to take this fight to the ground, but you can see that, oh, nice, with an inside pressing kick delivered by Natalie.
And the spinning back fist. This is where Hills wants to fight. Big right hand from her. And Angela Lee knows she's in a fight. She gets wrestled to the ground, a bit like a rag doll.
See, I think it's a mistake for Natalie to chase her down to the ground. She should let this fight go and get back up to her feet.
We'll
this is
see.
Where Angela is at home.
You could well be right.
Look at that sweep.
Fantastic sweep. Listen to this crowd.
See, this is not where Natalie wants to be, on the receiving end of Angela's grounded pound here. Angela's trying to step over and get into the full mount. Natalie's got to try to push away. She's got to let go of that head and start creating space.
Should she have just let her stay down there and not chased her? That's Mitch's opinion, and it looks as if it might have been the most sensible course of action. Takes a kick to the face. Technical ground kick. Lee comes down with punches.
Armbar. Possible armbar coming up here. He's just in mount. This is not good.
This crowd making an absolutely deafening noise behind us and all around this arena.
See, she's trying to clinch and trying to bridge out. She's got to let go and create space and move, create a scramble. Don't turn. She's turned the back.
The fucking Bronco action meant she gave up her back. Now what can Angela do?
Angela's probably going to try to, she's only got one hook in, so she only has one hook on the inside of Angela's leg. If she can secure the other foot on the other side of the leg, she's going to have a much more dominant position and probably work from the chokes.
Can't get all the way around just now.
Now she's kind of rolling her over here.
Natalie's cut.
And this, she could be setting up the twister here, Steve.
Wow, what a finish. That's an unbelievable finish. What was that?
Steve, she finished her with the twister. It is a submission where you crank on the spine. If you don't tap, you will rip your opponent in two.
That is a crazy finish.
That is tremendous. That shows you she is learning from the champions that evolved mixed martial arts. That is one of Shinya Aoki's favorite submission moves.
I wonder who she learned it from then. Wow. And I think there are some tears there. Not just because of the win, but the nature of the win. What a way.
You can see here, Angela gets tossed to the ground by Natalie. Natalie right there should have stood back up and disengaged and let Angela come back up. A beautiful sweep to Angelo back on top where she delivers some ground and pound. And you can see here, she secures the arm. I don't think Natalie knew what she was doing. And then she just starts cranking on the neck right there for some twist or submission.
That's a crazy finish. And there are indeed tears. For an athlete to accomplish a finish like that, it's no wonder it's emotional.
That is the first twister in ONE Championship history.
Ladies and gentlemen, to present the prize, we have Scott Jung, Managing Director of LG Electronics Singapore. Ladies and gentlemen, referee Olivier Coste calls a halt to this battle at 2 minutes 24 seconds of round number one for your winner by submission via twister, Angela Lee!
Wow, unique in the history of ONE Championship. Angela Lee, the first person to win via twister. What a performance. And this crowd were absolutely rocking.
Ready, choke! Will it be the old school, nasty, mean Shinya Aoki? How will he handle the striking of the human highlight reel FT?
Interesting choice of opening moves for Evting to attempt that high kick. That's going to allow Shinya to get in tight. Oh, no. He's immediately got it to the ground. He's passing into side control. Evting does a good job to get back into half guard. But watch Aoki step over. And check out that left leg.
In the opening seconds of this mixed martial arts contest, Evting on his back, Aoki on top.
Ting's got to hold of that head, but he's got to let go of that head and start pushing away. Shinya Aoki, he's actually helping Aoki. You don't want to get, you want to create space when you're defending, you know? And by holding the head like this, he's keeping Aoki tight to him. And there's also a choke right here. Here comes the arm triangle.
Is it going to be an early finish? Is it Ting in trouble? He's going to sleep. He's going to sleep. He's going to sleep. It's the mean, the nasty, the rampaging Shinya Aoki. Shinya Aoki, the number one contender for the lightweight championship.
Wow, Shinya Aoki got the choke. He did exactly what I said he was gonna do. He wanted to avoid the damage, close the distance. Look at him traveling deep into the upper decks to celebrate with his fans. I think he's forgot that he needs to get back down here.
This is what Aoki did last time. He scaled the stairs, went to the upper rafters, and he's done it again. He put the lights out literally on Evting. Evting went to sleep.
And he jumped from the top of the rafters down. That's like a 15-foot drop right there, Michael.
Amazing scenes inside the Impact Arena. That's the Shinya Aoki of old. The relentless mean streak is back. Now the number one contender. Of course, the lightweight title will be decided November 23 in Manila between Edward Folaye and Amir Khan. And the winner will face Shinya Aoki. My word, that was awesome. Let's go to Dominic Lau.
Ladies and gentlemen, to present the medal for this match, we have Kun Satisakai Pat. Area Business Manager, Chevron Thailand. And now, ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Olivier Coste, has put a stop to this contest after 57 seconds in the first round for your winner by way of arm triangle, Shinya Aoki.
Aoki, what planet do you come from? 26 submissions now in 42 wins. Three first round finishes in a row over Shannon Wirichai, Russell Yakiyaye, and now Evting.
Estela Nunez has shown us that she is here to stick around and do some damage while she does. And she starts this first round pretty much as she did, sorry, this second round pretty much as she did the first, with good hands. And Angela Lee will have to be very careful of that overhand right from Nunez, and that landed right on the button.
Estela Nunez survived the worst possible scenario. That has to have her confidence really high heading into this second round with the champion.
Remember, as Nunez sets up this attack with her fists, her real power comes from her legs. She can kick up to the head with devastating results. And Angela Lee will be mindful of that.
See, immediately Angela Lee is cutting off the angles, trying to get her pressed up against the cage. Typically, Angela doesn't like to shoot for a lot of takedowns. She gets most of her takedowns from the clinch position. So that's what Nunez has to be careful of in this next round.
It's quite clear that Angela wants the full contact. She wants to get in there close and nullify the attack that Nunez can provide in the stand-up.
Caught the kick, went for the takedown, and delivered a knee as she was pinned up against the cage there.
More knees to the head. Estela gets up on her feet, though. Angela tries to pull her down.
So she's got her in a darce choke position, one hand under the neck, the other hand laced under her arm. She's trying to snap her down, goes for the outside trip. That's an anaconda choke, Steve. Collapses beautifully in the anaconda. That's tight.
She's saying she's okay. She's giving Olivier Cost the thumbs up. Tremendous resistance again from Estela Nunez.
Right there, she has to frame off her hands, create a little bit of space with that right arm. So the arm is, she's essentially getting choked with her own arm.
She's still giving Olivier the thumbs up. Tremendous resistance from the Brazilian, but Angela Lee's attack is furious.
Look at Nunez, her head is pressed up against the side there of Angela Lee. Angela Lee has both arms nice and tight, but there is space for Nunez to breathe. Her right arm is not completely tight to her back.
I think she touched it, she's done it. It couldn't last forever. Angela Lee has made her second successful defense of a world title. The tears are already falling. She's done it again. The roar around me at the Singapore Indoor Stadium is deafening. Into the arms of her father, Ken Lee, who's coached her since she was a young girl. And the emotion is evident for all to see. The resistance from Estela Nunez was strong. And right up until the very final moment, it looked like it was going to continue. But there's the relief. A picture for all of Singapore to look at and be proud. Christian Lee, her brother, giving her a hug. Mitch, take us through these final moments. Rich Franklin is with us as well. Rich, just take us through these final moments.
I'll tell you, it's just to watch Angela Lee do this. I mean, she's been able to pull off an anaconda, a twister, guillotine chokes, arm bars. It's crazy. And you know, you saw her prior to this actually working the snap down, trying to earn that takedown. And then she was set in this kind of anaconda choke position from the standing position the whole time and ended up working it to the trip where she earned that position. It's just amazing to see the different angles that she's able to work various submissions from. She's always looking for something.
Well, Dom Lau has the official decision, and you can bet that it is going to be met with rapturous cheers from the crowd here in Singapore.
Ladies and gentlemen, to present the belt for this bout, we have Mr. Roger Chen, GoDaddy's Vice President of Asia. And now, your referee, Olivier Cost, has put a stop to this fight after 2 minutes and 18 seconds in the second round. For your winner, by way of anaconda choke, and still one women's atomweight champion of the world, unstoppable Angela Lee!
Estela Nunez falls to 5-1. The champion, Angela Lee, improves to 8-0. She screams at the camera. Victor Kui has the honor of putting that belt around her waist. She retains her title. The confetti comes down from the skies. We're drenched in it here at Cageside and are happy to be so. It's been a wonderful night's